one, come on, please.
Thank you. Close. Today we're on the north, on the other side of the track, so we need a little bit of right rudder,
okay.
not being pulled towards the track.
So that much will do?
Yeah, it's hard to judge from here, but
okay.
Yeah. Sinks, that's a good sign. Which way are they turning? Yeah, but we need to turn in the same direction as them.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. really now the game is keeping the attitude and the bank as constant as possible.
Yes.
Every third of a turn we want to have a look on the inside if there is not another glider.
Yes.
So we want to look as far back as the wing, okay?
Okay.
And we can try to be a tiny bit slower, around 48-50.
Over there.
So the bridge over there,
yeah.
There is the bridge on going between Bristol and Wales.
By the way, during the launch, what's the beep in your GoPro?
Sorry?
What's the beep in your GoPro after the launch?
I think so, yeah.
Okay, it's just I thought mine might have turned off. So it's a lot about feeling the thermal as well, isn't it?
Yeah. So now we kind of settled in the thermal. We can think, is there a side of our turn which is better than the other? So this side is not really good, because we're just doing the one or something like that.
I'm not sure.
And this side is a bit better because we're doing 2-3. Okay?
Yeah.
So we want to move our circle a bit towards the river.
Yes.
Okay? So...
straighten out in a minute.
So we... not now, but... at the so kind of now, we're going to straighten. So look out before you straighten to the right, the body, okay? Okay, and now we go back into the turn to the left. Okay, we still have this side is not very good
no.
compared with the other one.
So we push a bit more.
So we'll do it again, yeah? So look out before you...
yes.
Out, yeah. Okay, and turn. Okay, a bit more bank I think we can do. If we use a bit more bank to keep our 50 knots, you'll need a bit more trim to the back. Right, you see the T6 above us?
Yes.
Okay. That's kind of as close as I want to be. I don't want to be
okay.
much closer than that. Okay, when we get into a big surge of lift like that,
yes.
we want to tighten up. We don't want to speed up, so we want to go back to around 48-50. Titan. Very much.
No.
You see the number on top on the radio?
Oh yes.
It does the average of 30 seconds.
Yes.
So we haven't climbed in the last 30 seconds. Okay. So we need to think about moving a bit.
I think we should head. Over.
So I think we should head into wind. You see the cloud at 9 o'clock, at 3 o'clock behind the wind?
Yes.
Yeah, so we should go over there. Let's see. Well, except we bump into a thermal now, so let's try turning here.
Here?
Yeah, to the right. Doesn't really work. Okay, let's go back to our original point. And so we're trying to go somewhere and there's a bit of sink, so we can go at 60. We're going over the airfield, but we are at 1700, so, and we are on the launch point side, so
yes.
That's fine. Okay, so which cloud are we going to? The one slightly to the right or the one straight to edge?
To the right, I think.
Okay, right, so let's be right under it, yeah. Okay, so now we're approaching the cloud, so we just want to be two fingers on the stick so that we can feel which wing is going to go up.
Okay.
We want to be at 48. To level the wing now. And let's turn now. Maybe a bit too late. But
awesome.
Yeah. Okay, let's go to that cloud then.
This one here?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so we turn a little bit early.
Okay, so if I straighten up again afterwards.
Yeah. To stay here so we can retrim so that we got a good speed constant at 48. Okay, we could be summering with a bit more bank than that.
Okay.
So, but we don't want to speed up speed, to take speed, so
yeah, I just saw it.
Joining us, so that's a good sign. Okay, tighten up, tighten up.
I've just seen the tow plane.
Yeah.
Scared it.
Yeah. Okay, so let's go back to 50 knots. Okay, so now this thermal is quite good, and we see that we're getting a bit close to the cloud. So we need to start thinking, where are we going to go next?
I'd like to go over to where's Aston Downs from here? Is it far?
Yeah, it's far. It's at 1 o'clock now.
Okay, so...
Okay, keep turning. We haven't... It's a good thermal. We're going to take it all the way to the top.
Okay.
Except we... Right, we lost it. No. Okay, tighten. So Aston Down are the hangars at 10 o'clock.
Oh yeah, is it that light circle there?
It's a greenish hangar. Yeah, the semicircular hangar, yeah.
Okay.
We're doing under one as an average, so we're going to move.
Okay, where to?
So, okay, roll out. So we're going to take this little bit of cloud above us, straight above us, look up.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, and then we're going to go, okay, now we go slightly to the left to take this little bit of cloud. In the T13. Okay, nope, that's enough. You know, that's a little bit of cloud here.
There.
Yeah. And then which cloud am I going to?
We could go straight ahead or right.
Yeah, so we'll go a bit to the right. So you see, so right, okay, 70 degrees. Okay, straight now.
Is
okay, so we used all the little bit of cloud on the way.
Yeah.
Because, yes, we could go to Aston Down, but if we're not careful, we're going to land at Aston Down.
Yes.
Okay, so this little bit of clouds are actually a little bit to the right of us. So we just want to move the glider a little bit to the right.
Oh, I'm going quite slow.
Yeah, because we're going down and so we want to be at least at 55. Okay, we want to go under that cloud at 12:30. Okay, so when we're going straight, we're never really going straight, but still we need to keep a good lookout.
Yeah.
Along the horizon and maybe up, and because we want to keep our situation awareness so that when we want to turn, we can turn. Okay,
yes.
Let's turn a bit to the right, see if that cloud gives us a bit. Okay, let's turn more here. Wasn't a very good idea. So we'll finish our turn and we'll continue. Which cloud are we going to go now?
We could go to the one to the right.
Yeah.
That looks like a nice one.
Okay, so 55. Because we're going at minus 4. Oh, what's the speed doing? Why are we back at 50? Okay, so your left hand should practically leave on the trim lever and you should be retrimming every 30 seconds or something like that.
Okay. So is that Aston Down straight ahead?
Yep.
Oh yeah, is it the two cross runways?
Yeah, okay. Let's try a big turn, a wide turn to the right, see if we find a thermal. And there's this cloud. Can you still see Nympsfield?
Oh yes, I can.
Yeah. Will we be back to Nympsfield?
Yes, I think so.
Okay, keep turning to the right, a bit more bank, so we go back on the dark bit of the cloud. But that doesn't work too much, yeah? Okay. Right, do we see any Aston Don gliders summering?
No.
No, okay, let's go straight to it, see if we might one of those crowd work. Right, so Aston Don, do you see their launch point?
Yes.
Okay. So they're using the runway which go north south. Do you see the winch?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Okay, so a bit faster because we're going down. A bit faster, and we're back to 50. So that tells me that you didn't retrim.
Straight below it. Oh yes. What one's that one then?
Yeah.
Which is that?
That's Kemble.
Kemble and Aston Down, okay.
Yeah. Oh okay, so now there's a glider above us.
Oh yes.
Okay, so we're going to try to join his turn. Okay. So which direction is he turning?
Oh right.
Yes. And his turn is actually quite a bit further along. Well, we have a problem that we're a bit low to be above the winch. Okay, so turn here. Right.
Control.
Going to try getting us climbed a bit because
yeah.
I don't really fancy landing at Aston Don.
Slowly getting up, wasn't I?
Yeah.
On the average, it said 0.7. one below us, but he's quite far away.
Okay. Okay, you have control?
Okay.
Right.
I have control.
Between Aston Down and Nympsfield, there is 10 kilometers.
Yes.
Okay. How many feet are we going to lose if we were to go straight to Nympsfield?
2,000. I'd say.
No, we'd be around 1,100. Okay. So all the glass training glider and the Astier and stuff like that.
Yes.
They do 30 for one if there is no wind.
Yes.
So they will lose 1,000 feet for 5 miles or 1,000 feet for 9 kilometers. Okay? So
yes.
Today we got a bit of wind from the side, so that's going to be a bit against us, and it's a bit more than 9 kilometers, so. So that's why I'm saying 1,100 or 1,200.
Yes.
So that's if there is no big sink and stuff like that.
Yes.
So now we are 2,500. So now we kind of set. If we want to go back to the to Nympsfield, we will get there when we will be at around 1,200, or so there'll be plenty of margin.
Okay, I just want to get a bit more height on.
Oh yeah, yeah. No, I'm just discussing.
Okay.
But we have very good air. Look, you look the averager, we're doing 4.5,
yeah.
2.3, so.
Really nice thermal.
And sometimes it's even peak at 5 or 6, so there is no reason to leave until we are in the clouds. So then we're going to go towards Gloucester.
Okay.
Do you know where is Gloucester?
I think so, yeah.
Okay, so next turn, tell me when you see Gloucester.
I'll tell you when it's on the nose.
Yep.
Now, I think.
Okay, yes. So we see there is some good clouds on the way. So that should be okay. Okay, 3,000 feet.
Okay, so I'm gonna leave here.
Okay.
So trim forward.
Yeah. Okay, and for 55 or 60. Okay, so we're going towards the new cloud. Which
okay.
side of the cloud are you going to go?
To the left of it.
Yeah, because the tops are a bit higher on the left, so it looks better on the left.
And there's a glider to our left as well, so join him.
I can't see the glider.
About 11 o'clock.
Ah, below us?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. See it now. Okay, so we want to be at 55 at least. Direction is the glider turning?
Anti-clockwise.
Yeah, so to the left, yeah? Okay, so if we start turning, we'll have to start turning to the left.
Yes.
Now we're fairly high, so we're going to turn only if it's a good thermal. It is a good thermal, so let's turn. Okay, we know it's a good thermal and that we're going to stay in the thermal, so we can retrim. go below 50, yeah, good. It's climbing okay, but not superbly. So at the end of next turn, we're going to continue towards Gloucester.
Okay.
And we're also already quite close to the cloud.
Yeah, and the glider below us.
Oh, the glider below us is okay. But if I was, like when we arrived at Aston Don, I would stay in that climb. But because we're already quite high, there is no point staying in it. Okay, you see the glider at 11 o'clock summering?
Yes.
So it's hard to see now.
I see him, yeah.
You see him? Okay, well, let's go and join this thermal. So wait, which direction is it turning?
Anti-clockwise.
Yeah, is that right or left?
Left.
Yes. Okay. Okay, so which speed are we going to take to go there?
It's 55.
Yeah.
Start turning here.
No.
Oh yeah.
You're never going to join this circle. So in your head, you need to try. You need to start trying to see a circle in the air. Okay. So it was just at this most right point, and now it's this most left point. Okay.
I see him.
Yeah. So when we thermal with other glider, we need to keep looking at the other glider. So
yes.
We have less time to look at the attitude and the bank angle, which means we need to be very well trimmed, that the glider keep doing what we want. Okay, we're getting quite close to the cloud base, so go straight here. Okay, now you see, if I ask you where are the other clouds now,
yes,
it'd be hard to say because we are in the bottom of that cloud.
Yes.
Okay, but what we see, we can see the shadow of the cloud on the ground.
Yes.
Okay, so when you get quite close to the cloud, you start looking at where are the shadows.
Yeah.
Okay, so we know the sun is set is to our 9 o'clock.
It says 1 at our 12 o'clock.
So yeah, so the one which is at 11 o'clock.
Yes.
The shadow is under our nose at 12 o'clock.
Yes.
Okay.
So if I head towards that one then.
So if we head towards that one, yeah.
As a glider over there as well, if you can see it.
Straight ahead or to the right?
Straight ahead.
I can't see it at the moment.
Okay, it's very far away, so.
Okay. Is he lower or higher than us?
I'd say he's lower.
Okay. And do you know where his Nympsfield?
Over to our left. Yes, I can just. Around there, yes, I can see it, yes.
Okay, will we manage to get to Nympsfield?
Yes, easily.
Yeah.
Just speed up a bit.
like in the distance there is some hills.
Oh yes.
That's the Malvern Hills.
Oh yes.
So from the mains on a good day you should be able to see them.
Yeah, we do.
Yeah.
Sight of the glider now, but so is that Gloucester to our right?
So to our right is Gloucester. Okay, then there is a bit of a gap and there is another town, and that's Cheltenham.
Oh yes.
And between Gloucester and Cheltenham there is an airport.
Yes, whereabouts is it? I can't see it.
Where we can't can't really see it.
Oh, okay.
It's a bit hard because I think they are quite hiding a bit in the shadow of the cloud. But I know it's here, but I can't see it at the moment.
Okay.
Towards the cloud, so maybe, yeah, so we slowed down a little bit, which is good. There is a glider at 1 o'clock, far away.
Yes, I see it. A little bit of sink, that's a good sign. I was just looking at something and I thought it was something else, but we're ages away from it, so it's not.
Okay, so we return for the thermal. We go between 45 and 48. Is getting better in the thermal and which side do I need to move my circle?
Yeah.
Okay, and from time to time we look up, checking that.
Yes.
Looking at the cloud.
Okay. Ah, there's a cloud, I see.
Yeah,
it, so
it's joining us.
This one. Yeah. So I need to put more bank on it. Radio on it?
No.
Okay, so we're not allowed to go near it then?
Yeah. straight here. So you see there's some shadow on the ground.
Yes.
Yeah, so let's go to that. I'm not sure I would go all the way to it, but just to see.
I see it on the nose now, the airfield. But
okay, good. You have control?
I have control.
So that airfield, it's a Gloucestershire airport.
Yeah.
The name of the village is Staverton, so sometimes we call it Staverton.
Yeah, Staverton, yeah. And I've been there before.
Okay, so they got three runways.
Yeah.
They're a big runway in which they got an instrument approach, go east-west.
Yeah.
And then they got a runway which goes south-north.
Yeah.
And then there is one which goes northeast-southwest.
Yeah, and they were very busy during the Cheltenham races as well, don't they?
Yeah, yeah. So I imagine today they will be using the north-south runway, but they might also use also the east-west at the same time.
Yes.
And have you... I know you don't have already your bronze, no?
No, I don't.
So you'll see when you start learning for the bronze. This airport only has an ATZ, so the control zone is fairly small. And it stops at 2,000 feet above the airfield, which is 2,100 feet above the sea, which is 1,400 above Nympsfield.
Yes.
Okay, we'll see if we can climb under this cloud a little bit.
Okay.
And then we turn back, because by the time we land it'll be 1 hour.
Yeah.
Or 55 minutes, something like that.
And that's the M road there as well, isn't it?
Sorry?
Is that the M54?
No, that's the M5.
Okay.
Okay, where is Nympsfield?
It was just near our nose.
Yeah, it was near our nose. Okay, so well banked, we retrim under 50 knots.
Get over.
We which is the lookout buoy.
Yes.
There's a glider at 11 o'clock, very low.
Oh yes, I see it. So straight ahead on our nose,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah, straight to Nympsfield. We want to go straight to the point where we're going to start our circuit.
Okay.
So where is Ike?
It'll be around there.
Yeah. I'm going to shut down a bit the radio because we're going down.
Okay.
And we can go to 60 knots at least because we got plenty of light. How does the
go fast? Feels like it's vibrating more.
Okay.
And it moves more, like more. It reacts more.
Okay.
Reacts. Yeah, that's the word.
It's a bit hard to hear you.
Yeah. Glider to our right.
Yep.
Glider to our right. It's fixed.
Yeah.
Sight, it, there's one watch just landed, so I'm going to make my touchdown zone a bit later if it hasn't moved. And air brakes are here.
Okay.
So I'm going to speed up to 55 now. Should be turning final at 400, so might have to.
Right, so where are we going to go?
I'm going to go over the aircraft once it landed.
Go left a bit.
Left.